So do-si-do. This we ended with the last time, but it was just a fast little walkthrough. So this is how it looks. So it's got a little pump to it, right? And you can tell there's some quick parts, and so you just want to keep your steps small on those sections. I don't do those heel jacks, like, you know, because you'll never catch yourself, right? Just keep them small right under you. It helps that I'm on the stage a little bit. It keeps me a little confined. Okay, there are no tags, no restarts. So that's good. This is a Rachael dance. It was on the top of the charts for a long time. And I suspect that we're going to see it come up, you know, many times. It might be, it was a jam dance that we didn't have jam, but it was nominated right at the very end. So I suspect it'll be on next year's. So we're going to do two heels, right and left, and step, pivot a quarter. So everything's syncopated there, but don't think so much about the steps in between the steps. So you do a right heel, a left heel, a right step, and pivot. Two walks, right, left, and then they call it a C bump. Rachael really likes these because in Dip to the Bass we had one where you kind of hitch up and then down with a little hip hop. But as long as you just turn up, down, right? So you don't have to make it a big C, but it's just kind of this motion up, down. So we just pivoted, pivot, turn, we're walking right, left, up, and then sit on your right. Kind of dig my left toe because that keeps my weight in the right place. All right, so with the counts, starting with our right, ready? We're gonna do one and two and three, four, walk five, six, up seven, down eight. So there's our first eight count. Now, we're gonna go to this diagonal and we're going to do a step, lock, step, lock, step. So not unfamiliar with that pattern, right? Step, lock, step, lock, step. This is where we're gonna do a tap, tap, stomp. So you kind of move it forward a little bit. Tap, tap, stomp. Yeah, and on that stomp is when you wanna finally put weight on that foot. So you're not being really heavy with it. Just be really light, tap, tap, stomp. And you're gonna end the eight count squaring up to your next wall, 3 o'clock, with pose, pose, which you just step left, right. Then as you get more comfortable with it, you can push your hips into those steps, left, right, or left, right. You know, there's one part, the very first time you do it, he says strike a pose, which is why she put those arms option in there, but you don't have to do it the whole time, only if you feel like it. So that eight, we just did our C bump. We're gonna go to this diagonal. Step, lock, step, lock, step, a tap, tap, stomp, out, out. I'm gonna do it with counts. So we did our C bump up and down. I love this mirror because y'all can kind of like see even though we're turned around the other way. So one, walk two, three and four, you tap five and six, then seven, eight. And it all happens very quickly. Let's walk through it from the top. Tippity top. All right, right heels, ready? And a one and two and three, pivot four, walk five, six, C bump, seven, and eight. One, two, lock, three, and four, tap it, five, and six, out, seven, out, eight. Yeah, how are we feeling with it? Good? So those are our first two eight counts. So seeing how many, I know it's more than, it's a 48, so it's more than 32 counts, it's a 48 dance. With our right foot again, from the top. Ready, and a one, and two, pivot, three, four, walk right, left, C, up and down, then left, lock, step, lock, step, a tap, tap, stomp, and out, up. Good? I'll keep going. So here is where we're gonna have our heel jack section. In essence, you're doing three, and then you're doing something that's similar to end it up. So you're gonna cross that left over the right, because you just stomped out left, right. Weight should kind of be more gravitated towards your right foot. So you're gonna do a cross and a heel, and a cross and a heel. So you do two of them just right here. Now the next one, we have to turn it. And don't get caught up too much on the angles. You're gonna do a cross and a heel. So as you do that third one is when you're gonna turn that quarter. Then you're gonna do a cross shuffle instead of a fourth heel jack. And cross shuffle. Yeah? So over here to the side, you just step out, out, left, right. I don't know, do you call that a left heel jack or a right heel jack? When you start with your left, but you're going right? I've seen it both ways on step sheets, so I don't know if there's a consensus, but you start with your left over your right. Ready? We're gonna go cross and a heel and a cross and a heel. Turn across and a heel and a cross shuffle. Yeah, see on the step sheet, on that heel jack, she has turn an eighth and an eighth. And to me, you just think, I'm gonna go a quarter to my next wall. All right, let's go from the top through that part. Ready, and a one, and two, and three, four, walk, five, six, bump at seven, and eight, lock at one, two, a three, and four, tap at five, and six, out, seven, out, eight, heels, one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six, and a seven, and eight. That section there is the quickest footwork. So if you can master that, that's gonna be the big hill to climb over. You can get that, then the rest is smooth sailing. All right, so we just did cross shuffle. Let's go from the top one more time. We're gonna speed it up just a tiny bit. And this is a two-wall dance. So now that we're halfway through, I'm gonna say we're gonna walk through it facing the other way. So let's just do this way first. Ready, and a one, and two, and three, four, walk at five, six, a seven, and lock, up one, two, a three, and four, tap at five, and six, out, seven, out, eight, and a one, and two, and three, and four, turn at five, and six, seven, and eight. All right, let's turn and face the mirror. Try the other way, brand new dance. No, same dance. Right foot, ready, and a one, and two, and three, four, walk at five, bump it, seven, and lock, one, two, a three, and four, tap, five, and six, out, seven, out, eight, heels, one, and two, three, and four, and a five, and six, cross shuffle, perfect. All right, so we're gonna keep going, y'all are nailing it. We're gonna be here, so we did our cross shuffle. This next part is very mirror imaged. So we're gonna do a side rock, behind side cross, and then kind of a side rock, behind side cross. You'll see what I mean, so we're gonna go side, rock, behind, side, cross. On this side, instead of a side rock, you're gonna go out with your foot and just do a pop, pop with your hips. Now you can just do a side rock, behind, side, cross. It's the same number of counts. So if that makes you feel more comfortable, you're not a hip bump person, you can just do two side rocks. So on the left first, we do a side rock, behind side cross, then a bump, bump, behind side cross. Yeah, it's nice and easy to remember with a little twist there. I'm gonna keep going because the next part's simple. I'm gonna break it down without a turn because I feel like the turn makes it very complicated. Then we can add the turn in once we get it. So all it is really is a rumble box with a shuffle. So you go side, together, forward, shuffle on the left, then a side, together, back, shuffle on the right. See, that seemed really simple, right? So let's put those two parts that we just learned together. We have side rock, ready, and a side rock, behind side cross, and a bump, bump, behind side box. Side, together, forward, shuffle, side, together, back, shuffle. Yeah, let's do all that with counts, then I'll show you a turn option. So we're here, ready, and a one, two, a three, and four, five, six, a seven, box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Good. So just stay with that if that is what you're comfortable with. Here's the turn option. So you are here, you're doing your rumba box. The first half of it is exactly the same. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Rachael has you, you're gonna take the same L-shaped pattern. You're gonna go back, forward, and then a triple shuffle half turn. So shuffle half turn. So you end on the same foot and you're taking the same pathway on the ground, just you're turning it a full turn. So you are here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Go back on the right, forward on the left, and then a half turn shuffle over your left shoulder. Okay, let's try that much. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Yeah? What makes this part harder too is the next part that comes, because you think you're done turning and you're not. So that's why I'm giving you the option to not turn, because then the next part seems very easy. So let's go ahead and go from the top before we add on that last little tricky bit. So starts with our heels. Yeah, turn, C bump, lockstep. Sound familiar? All right, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, 1 and 2, pivot 3, 4, walk at 5, 6, bump at 7, and lockstep. 1, 2, a 3 and taps, a 5 and 6, out 7, out 8, heel jacks, and 3 and 4 and 5 and 6, and a 7 and side rock. 1, 2, a 3 and 4, a 5, 6, a 7 and box. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. All right, let's try that again, and then we're going to do it to the other wall. So ready, and 1 and 2 and 3, 4, walk at 5, 6, a 7 and 8. 1, 2, a 3 and taps, a 5 and 6, out 7, out 8, heel jack in, 2 and 3 and 4, 5 and 6, and a 7 and 8, side rock, 2, a 3 and 4, a 5 and 6, a 7 and bump. 1, 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Good. Let's turn it around. We'll go through slowly. We just have the end to add on, which is going to be a little turn and then some heel swivels. So it's a little tricky ending, but we're almost there. So from the top, ready, and go. 1 and 2 and 3, 4, walk at 5, bump at 7, and lockstep. 1, 2, a 3 and taps, a 5 and 6, out 7, out, heel jacks. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, turn at 5 and 6, cross at 7 and 8, side rock. 2, a 3 and 4, 5 and 6, a 7 and 8, rumble box. 2, a 3 and 4, a 5, 6, 7 and 8. Good. Okay, let's go ahead and turn back to the front wall. Keep learning it all this way. So your weight ends back on your right foot. And I said we weren't done turning. So all you're gonna do, you came around this way, triple half turn. You continue that way for another quarter, but she doesn't call it a turn. She says your body's turning, but your head isn't. So it doesn't qualify as a turn. So you step side, touch. So I'm still on this wall, but notice my entire body turned a quarter. So you do your triple half turn on your right, 7 and 8. 1, 2, to reverse it a half, 2-step turn, 3, 4. You're gonna kick out, out, a heel, toe, together. So it's a little tricky ending there because you're spinning one way, spin back the other way, kicking out, and then this part threw me for a little bit because you're like, wait, wait, what do I do? And that's the end of the dance though. So we just gotta get this through this part. So we had our rumba box, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Keep going, 2, turn 3, half 4, a kick, out, out, a heel, toe, heel. So you're kicking with the right, step out, right, left, and then bringing your heels together, toes, and then together. And the way I trained myself to do that without having to think of it is I had to be thinking ahead and thinking, when I do my kick out, I already turn my feet in. Then I have no choice but to do my heels first. Then I don't even have to think about it. So practice doing that where you go kick and turn your toes in when you go out. Does that make sense? And then you're already there. If that still throws you, an option would be to go kick out, and then just bump your heels a bump, 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 and then you're ready to go. So I don't want that ending to fluster anybody enough that you can't start again the new wall. All right, so let's do that rumba box into that part. We'll turn it around and just do that part to the other way. So rumba box. I'm calling it a rumba box, but it's not really. We're doing a shuffle in there. But I know y'all know what I'm talking about. All right, so to the left. Ready, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Touch, 1, 2, half, 3, 4. A kick, out, a heel, toe, heel. Yes, okay, let's do that same exact thing facing this way, because that's the only thing we haven't done to the back wall. Rumba box, ready, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Touch it, 1, 2, 3, half, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. End of dance. No tag, no restart. So we need to walk through the entire thing to the front wall and the entire thing to the back wall. Y'all have any questions? No? Just more practice, right. So this is gonna be our first teach week. You'll have a week off because of Thanksgiving and I can't help it. But when we come back, we'll have a second teach. When we come back, then the following week, we'll just have a walkthrough and dance. So that'll be a good refresher when we come back. So no fear, if you don't get it all, and you just need more practice, there's plenty of time.
Yes.
So with your right foot to start, let's walk through a whole wall. Ready, and a 1, 2, 3. Walk it, 5, 6, bump, 7, and lockstep, 1, 2, a 3, 4, tap it, 5, 6, out, 7, 8, heel, jack, 2, 3, 4, turn it, 5, 6, and a 7, 8, rock, 1, 2, 3, 4, bump it, 5, 6, 7, and rumble box, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and touch, 1, 2, 3, 4, kick out, 6, 7, 8. Let's do another wall, ready? When we finish this wall, let's go the first 8 count into the next wall because you'll be facing me. That'll practice our ending into our beginning. Ready, and a 1, 2, 3, 4, walk, 5, 6, bump it, 7, 8. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, tap, 7, 8, heel, jack, 2, 3, 4, turn it, 5, 6, and a 7, 8, rock, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, a 7, and box, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, a 7, 8, touch, 1, turn it, 3, 4, 5, 6, keep going, 8, a 1, 2, 3, 4, walk, 5, 6, bump, 7, 8. Okay, it's a little bit quicker with the music, but it'll feel better than just listening to me counting. Good, let's try it with music. Oop, my music's over here. It's a little bit quicker. We'll do it and we'll get some water and then we'll do it again. But we might do it again after we do a round of I close my eyes so we can just kind of relax. Lock, step, tap, out, heel jab. almost there. There you go.
Something catch the breeze.
That's the end. We'll tell you how to anticipate that coming in a minute. But yes, good job, you guys. Get some water. That's a fast-paced one.
That part is really fast.
I'll work on it.